I'm Shreeman. Welcome to part 2 of my note-taking video. But I'll be showing you guys an example of how you guys can take notes for your school. Introducing the 4-quadrant note-taking structure. It's not something that's complicated. I'll show you guys in a minute. What is the 4-quadrant note-taking structure? You split the page into 4 quadrants, and on the top left, you put the chapter number. And then you put the heading on the top. Okay, so if it's a chapter heading like atomic structure or dynamics or tourism, you put it on the top, all right? And then on the bottom left, you put in questions, and on the bottom right, you put your notes. And I'll be explaining each of the parts in greater detail throughout this video. First, what's in a heading, all right? And heading is basically the chapter heading, as I explained earlier. You have tourism, you have atomic structure, you have dynamics, or it could be even physics and even chemistry as well. And this brings me to an important point that your heading sets a macro or micro scale to your notes, and hence it's really important. So if your heading is really macro, like chemistry, like physics, then your notes are going to be really broad, more concise and less detailed, okay? But if your headings are really micro, so they're very focused on topics like aldehydes and ketones, really specific, it's going to be less concise and really much more detailed. Next, what are questions and why do questions work? Okay, basically what you do with questions on the bottom left corner, right, is to convert chapter concepts into questions. So within a chapter, if they have different titles, all right, to address each point, like what is s orbital, what is the p orbital, what are orbitals, you put them as questions. These work because according to a book called How to Win Friends and Influence People, right, that you can ask questions instead of giving direct orders. It helps your mind think much better, all right? Examples of such questions, for those of you guys who are wondering aimlessly, like, what am I trying to say, can be like, what are economic impacts of tourism? What is electronic configuration in the case of chemistry? And questions really work because you're asking questions instead of giving direct orders. And when you do that, you force your mind to recall and retrieve the knowledge, not just reread and reread the same notes again and again, which is a waste of time. And a lot of you guys are doing it, and it doesn't work, and it doesn't work for me as well. So what I learned is, right, what I do during exams is that I cover the right-hand section, the notes section, and look at the questions, and I force my mind to retrieve the knowledge and answer these questions. And if I get it wrong, I flip to the notes and look at what I can correct, and it really helps. Okay, now this is an example. So you put, for example, chapter 1 is atomic structure, and you ask your first question, what is s orbital, indicate subheading 1, and then the sub details, subheading 2, the sub details. So the subheading 1 could be like shape, subheading 2 could be direction. And then before you go to the next question, you insert a small line or a border, and then you go to the next question, like what is the p orbital, and then you just do the same thing again. More importantly, what are examples 1 and what are examples 2? In the case of geography, right, these examples could be like places. Or in the case of English, these examples could be like places, like Cairo, Egypt, or Mangalore, India, which you'd like to address in your essays for geography. Or it could also be application questions you have done in worksheets or tutorials or test papers before, and you've learned important lessons or learned from your mistakes. You can write it down in the example section as well. All right, the things that you guys should take note is that your notes should be simple and structured. This is something that I raised in part 1 of my note-taking video. So for those of you guys who have not watched that video, do click on the link in the description or click on the link up in the video as well, okay? So you can use black for numbers, headings, and borders. You can use blue for the questions and notes, and you can use red for examples or any other color that suits you the most. Your heading should be of a suitable scale. If your headings are really macro, then your entire notes is going to be really broad and macro. Likewise, if your headings is micro, then the entire notes is going to be really detailed and really on the micro level. So your headings have to be of a suitable scale, and I recommend that you guys should make both macro as well as micro notes, okay, using macro and micro headings. Two types of notes for the same concepts does help you get good grades for your exams, right? And there should be consistency across one page, which is the most important point. I don't want you guys to put mind maps and this table or this four quadrant thing both on one side of the page. Because if you do that, your mind is probably going to get confused, or your mind gets dozed off reading your notes halfway. Stick to a simple and structured way throughout the page that's uniform. And then when you flip to the next page, then you change your style of notes, all right? So what if you guys don't want to write your notes and you want to type out your notes, for example, on Google Docs? Then what you guys can do is to insert a 2xN table, okay? So go to the insert button and click on tables and you insert a 2xN table, so N rows. So if you have N questions you want to put, then N rows, all right? Then you adjust the margins so that it's not like four equal quadrants and like one is bigger and one is smaller, like I showed you earlier. And then this is the most important point. Instead of using example and trying to find the exact shape or the circle or the oval, use comments. So highlight the piece of text that you guys want, okay, using your mouse, and then click on the comment section and add your example in comment. No one is going to see it, okay? It's only for you. And it helps, okay? Because it doesn't, the comments don't take space on the page. It's like outside of the page. So thank you guys for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel as I'll be making more of these videos, and share this video with your friends who may need help taking notes as well. Let's go structure and stay tuned for my next video.